Let's go straight to the top story at this hour. PM Modi will be leaving for a two-day visit today to two Indian nation island countries, which is Maldives and Sri Lanka. While with Maldives, the focus is to strengthen ties with the Soli government. With Sri Lanka, it's to send a message of solidarity in the aftermath of the 21st April terror attacks. Now, our principal diplomatic correspondent, Sidhan Sibyl, gives you the details on what to expect on Modi's trip.
In his first visit abroad after taking charge for a second term, Prime Minister Modi will be visiting Maldives and Sri Lanka. It is after 8 years that an Indian Prime Minister will be on a state visit to the Maldives. The last was by Manmohan Singh in 2011. During the visit, Prime Minister will address the Maldivian Parliament, the Majlis, and meet the top leadership. In the last 8 months, since the new government led by President Soli took charge in November last year, there have been a number of high-level visits, including by the President of Maldives, Foreign Minister Abdullah Shahid, and Defence Minister Maria Ahmed Didi.
The Prime Minister's visit is essentially focused on three objectives. Firstly, it is to maintain contacts at the highest level between close neighbours. Secondly, we want to assist the Maldives as their development partner in the revival and development of their economy. And thirdly, of course, is to strengthen the people-to-people relationship we have with the Maldives.
For strengthening defence partnership, both Prime Minister Modi and President Soli will jointly inaugurate two defence-related projects. One is the coastal surveillance radar system that will help Mali preserve its sovereignty in the EEZ, or the Exclusive Economic Zone. And another will be a composite training center for Maldives National Defense Forces. The total value of the two projects is $180 crore.
Well, it's a very historic visit. So all preparations are in place. It's a big honor for us that Prime Minister visit is being accorded the status of a state visit. And that is the status which is usually reserved for visits by heads of state. In our case, they made an exception.
On cricket, the Maldivian side is keen to have its own cricket team and a cricket stadium and asked for Indian assistance. India has given cricket kits and is expected to coach Maldivian cricketers. India had sent a team of BCCI in May. And finally, on connectivity, India is planning to start a ferry service from Kochi in Kerala to the Maldives, which the Foreign Secretary said will significantly enhance connectivity. India is also working on 14 high-impact community projects, which involves connectivity within the island and speedboats for Maldivian students. On 9th June, Prime Minister will mark a short and packed visit to Sri Lanka while coming back from the Maldives. This visit is being described as a visit to show solidarity with the people of Sri Lanka.
I would sum up this visit to Sri Lanka as firstly showing solidarity with the people and the government in the wake of the tragic events of the 21st of April and expressing our confidence in the government of Sri Lanka in overcoming this national tragedy.
Prime Minister will be the first foreign leader to visit Sri Lanka after the 21st April terror attacks that killed more than 250 people. Sri Lankan President Maithripala Sirisena had visited India last week for the oath-taking ceremony of Prime Minister Modi for his second term. Modi visited Sri Lanka twice in his first term, first in March 2015 when he travelled to Anuradhapura, Talimannar and Jaffna, and then in 2017 when he was the chief guest at the Vesak Day celebrations.
The visit by Prime Minister Narendra Modi to Maldives and Sri Lanka sends out a clear message that for New Delhi, neighbourhood first will be the top priority for the next 5 years. While in Maldives, focus will be on defence, cricket and connectivity. In Sri Lanka, India will be sending a strong message of solidarity for the people and the government of Sri Lanka in the aftermath of the 21st April terror attack, which killed more than 250 people. With video journalist Bala Sidhan Sibyl for WION in New Delhi.